ninja.
Someone asked a question in the forum today, top of the page, so I gave the best answer I could offer to think of the best way to say it, you know? Said, what would you do if you were verbally attacked? I counterattack until you get blocked for harassment when you snap back like it's a fucking jihad in Iraq. Lay into the back of the cranium just like they just smoked some fucking crack, and every word that came out of the mouth fell right off the track. Stack it up till it's practically nuts. The way you trash the fucking office for fun. We'll be calling the cops cause I won't stop tailgating the motherfuckers in the fast lane. Cut them off till they crash in a big fucking disaster and vanish in a fucking flash. Yeah, I probably got some anger problems, we can talk about it, but not if you expect me to not be pissed off 24/7. Some of us are carrying way too much pain and some very complex variables to put it into medication. Puts us into hysteria when someone's comparing you to their kids or their parents. You think I'm doing this just to be scary, or it's all just preliminary assumption of the itinerary? Well, no wonder you're ignorant as all hell and shit, you dumb bitch. You just dug yourself right into the bottom of a fucking ditch. The Matrix is about to glitch. The black cats are gonna be passing by the same underpass by the trash can. I've had way too many people try to tell me what they think or believe and what I should believe, only to watch them drown in a drink and do the exact opposite whenever they please. Oh yeah, that was different. Yeah, it was. Now your car, your truck's looking like some Swiss cheese. Blew out the pistons, now the whole fucking thing is looking a little crispin'. And again, this is just what I have to resort to before I metamorph into a cybernetic gort. Time for the nanobot export, writing to your message boards. Every other person who recommended I get suspended is gonna be second guessing the method that they forgot to cross-reference in the Borg collective. Just ignore the detective, you're already in corrections. You better be paying the protections to the Gestapo, Diablo, Don Capo insurrection. You might think I'm aggressive, but this is just a reflection. It's an automated course correction. I'm hyper-reactively over-possessive of my sanity, not to mention drowned in my own vanity. My brain is something of a cacophonous but calamity, so unless you're a shrink or you're a neurologist, just stop acting like I need you. You need me to become some fucking apologist just cause you lost your wallets or some shit. Call it whatever the fuck you wanna call it. My nanobots have already installed it. I try really hard to be a reasonable person right until you turn me into the alternate version. Even if I stepped on your toes, I might not have even known. Excuses, excuses, let them be known. Yeah, I grew up in a really fucked up home. No one told any of the people looking after me not to do any of this shit. If that's how you were raised, you might understand why I'm still unfazed. No, I did not get raised right, and that doesn't mean I hate anyone for that, alright? Why do you think I was attracted to these philosophies? Not just so I could become the next Mephistopheles. Bitch, please, to me this is way less fucked up than the third grade. If I ever said to your children what the people who tell me this was evil or whatever were compelled to, you might just follow me right into hell, dude. You better have brought a lot of Necronomicon text to be drawing on. This ain't a fucking Comic-Con. This is more like a Deimonicus XCOM. I hope you can at least got one bomb-ass spell, cause if you fuck this up yourself, create another outcast incel, you'll be looking at another delinquent spasmatic panic attack just like that. On anyone who tries to bust another case of Cracker Jacks out of the backpack, it doesn't mean I can't still put every single track on a platinum wall plaque. I might be crazy, but it doesn't mean I'm wrong. Just listen to the fucking song before you start telling me what you think it means to be right or wrong. Try smoking a bong or something, cause I can make you forget the difference before long. So to summarize, the next time someone tries to bully you online, show them the meaning of giving someone a hard time. It just ain't worth your fucking time, buddy. Is there a price? Is there a right price to be bribing the zeitgeist? Nick Nine, Duck for them Schlager thugs is what you're gonna find inside me. So please, I enjoy being bullied. It gives me a much needed relief. It's an excuse for me to turn into the biggest asshole you ever seen in this castle. Suck it up, buttercup, gingerbread muffin. They don't call me douchebag infinitus for nothing. It's through and through. I got nothing better to do than fuck around with you if you really want to waste the rest of your life doing nothing. I'm happy to oblige being rude next time it turns into fine and some food and my rhymes in between all the crimes that I definitely did not do. Yeah, exactly. No one ever needed to know.
Okay, welcome back. Do we get to... No, we're finally at the nuking everything part, guys. Someone was waiting for it. Yeah, it was... Is there a way to survive a big motherfucking bomb? Yeah, the biggest motherfucking bombs that have ever been built. That's what they're called. Moab. Yeah, mother of all bombs. Massive ordnance airburst. Or the big motherfucking bomb. I'm not even joking, dude. I'm just saying. It's like the Panzergeist. Yeah, what is that? Yeah, what the fuck does that mean? Yeah, the German guy doesn't know what that means. That's the fucking point, buddy. Yeah, no wonder it was so fucking confusing. Goddamn, yeah, Mindspiels. Yeah, Colonel Hoppy's fucking Mindspiels. He knows, he fucking knows. Someone might be catching on. Again, rhetoric, buzzwords. Where do I start? Let's start by brainwashing you up the nostril with a toothbrush. Let's get rid of some of the clutter. That's something almost anyone can do. If you're not a hoarder, if you're willing to, I mean, what is more or less valuable than whatever else, right? I was talking about artificial intelligence a while ago. In my opinion, thinking, holding on to every single piece of information is 100% gospel truth. Or believing everything that you are told is, almost like a robot. Oh, okay, the robot can't tell that it's a joke. Ha ha. That's just as stupid, and you would notice that there is something wrong with this person. You would think of it as a problem just as much as thinking everything is a lie. One way or another, communication, trying to communicate with someone like that, there are certain barriers. Someone who's always tells the truth or always lies or always doubts what you says or always believes you, it's like, you will inevitably reach, you can't say that, why not? It's like, what do you mean? No, you just, it's like, how do you know that? Yeah, straight up. If no one can ever say this word in your perfect little world, how do you even know it? The only way you would know this rule is if one of us reminded you, you need me, you need Dr. Satan, to remind you of all the bad shit you're going to tell me not to do. Straight up you do. Or what? You gonna call a gang of raccoons, motherfucker? No, we're gonna get the fucking caveman nukes and the howitzers. The what? Oh, shit. Okay, so let's go through this step logically. Imagine, who do we call to get this done? Oh, our phone just rang. Yeah, that's us. Yeah, who do we? Yeah, dude, if we can't, we better know how to do this. If someone else is better at this, are you better at this? If someone is. That's the whole thing. Yeah, sure, science man, whatever. Welcome to Super Mario's fucking galaxy of fucking mindspiels. Yeah, there better be at least one crazy Viking Science Academy here. Whatever, guys. Even if it's just to take some reefer from the Dutch Netherlands, you know I'm good for it. I'd rather not nuke the Dutch Netherlands. I'm sure there's speculation about this. Guys, one of them's thinking, it's like, do you really think the news would over there says we're evil and we have to fight the good guys? Yeah, no, every country, that's not even, I'm sure they say, we got to go fight those bad guys, whatever you want to call them, the tyrants, the overlords, Even some people are more or less smug about it in one way, that matters more during an investigation, less so 10,000 years after the fact. I can cut them a break, I can cut the Pharaoh a break, because, he is historical reference. He can't reference himself. He's writing the big list of mistakes for everyone else and then going straight up inventing CNN and Glue Dobbs by changing it later. Let's pretend this happened. Now we know. Thanks, buddy. Straight up. At least we know. It's like after Mohinder tags his name on everything in Vancouver. I've seen this before. And maybe it's pronounced differently. And Muhammad, I've seen this douchebag before. It's not Harminder. It's worth knowing these things. Sorry, guys. You might get it. The details, things that seem irrelevant until suddenly they're not irrelevant. Oh, now I realize what this stupid key was for. You might not have known that it was a key. Sorry to be so douchebag about it. Bordering on hipster territory. What's the point? All my stupid phrases, someone's thinking about it. The reason I talk like a nutcase is that you actually remember something. The caveman nukes. The caveman nukes. There's a reason. This whole time, I've said that 100 fucking times. Gestapo Diablo, motherfucker, where's Mario? Why is it a caveman nuke? A caveman could build it if he had reason to think of this. Me, what am I going to do today? I'm going to go get some food. I'm going to go look for uranium ore. What is that? You think they'd notice green glowing goo? They probably would notice big green glowing things. Maybe it's not a green glowing thing. It can be. call Dr. fucking scientist for this shit. I'm just saying, yeah, any douchebag can show up and make things more complicated for one reason or another. On the most fundamental level, you can smash rocks together and they will explode. That's how the what do you think happened to the dinosaurs? Two rocks smashed together and exploded and it killed almost everything on Earth? Yeah, did it kill everything on Earth, dude? Okay, I'm just saying, if you're bitching about a bunch of boring work to do, yeah, well, congratulations, now you have a lot of fucking boring work to do. This is one of those moments of science where now it is appropriate for me to be a hipster douchebag to you. Now I can start, what about this? What about the black holes? What about the fucking ions? Yeah, straight up, what about the ions? The neutrons in the water? Yeah, you better have an answer to all this shit now. Which is why, the hipster douchebag, the temporary hipster douchebag number 576, whatever. If we can agree beforehand on a hypothesis, yeah, you start with a hypothesis so that when I do throw a floppy dildo at it, it's just an inflatable practice dummy. Yeah, we can practice with your toys first before we do anything serious that we might regret. Yeah, yeah. Stay safe, everyone. Literally, figure out what you enjoy doing before taking any unnecessary risks. Once you start, you get it. It's like writing a book, and you want to write an entire novel and then realize you have to change everything. Or there are ways of writing drafts. Like, let's say you can't think of a name for a character. Oh God, yeah. This could be very inconvenient. You could really trip yourself up over this. What? Yeah, I could change the dude. X1, X2, X3, X4, whatever. Yeah, index, motherfucker. Find and replace all instances of X1 with douchebag infinitus. Oh, now that, what's his name? Let's change it to fucking Kaiser Caesar fucking, swift kick in the nuts, whatever. Prince fucking Peppercorn, Pepperidge Farm, forgot everything. You could change it to Pepperidge Farm. Control F or whatever the fuck it is in Notepad. Notepad Deluxe for $5, motherfucker. Once again, how did he do it? How did he do it indeed? Fucking Notepad Deluxe for $5. You're still on the dark web watching your hentai. Yeah, did you get any fucking work done? So the most certified experts of testing those things we were just talking about, they're thinking, okay, who's supposed to be, where's the fucking cable guy? Even the dumbest scientist here is like, right, I don't know everything, but okay, we need big motherfucking bombs. We need, some kind of fucking V-scaled rocketing. Stahlheit torpedo waffen rocketing. Yeah, your job is to take this the biggest motherfucking bomb anyone has ever built and deliver it right to the Pentagon. Yeah, exactly. Don't let anyone catch you. It's a 50 megatons. I'm a Hercules fucking pushing rocks like Sisyphus. Fucking sick of this. Straight up. It's like Groundhog Day met Sisyphus. Right. Even if one person could maybe do that, brah, we might need more than, goddammit, back to the first thing we ever learned, that's not good enough. And, okay, you get it, this is a hilarious thing, okay. Oh no, someone called the hipster douchebag department, the guy's in the basement working on tax receipts and shit. Straight up, hipster douchebag, tell us everything you know about the aliens. Dude, they got these crazy stealth bombers, oh, I'm sure they do. Call Dr. Fokkerwolf. What happened when you built the fucking... oh my god, Messerschmitt MV613 Cobra Suicide Torpedo... the Jägermeister, the fucking Master Huntsman of the Luftwaffe, he can fly it. The crazier your thing is, the less people can do it. Right, only one man has what it takes. If there's anything I can warn you about from our history, where is Superman? Where's the King of Sparta? Fucking John Wayne Imperator, Oh, he's sick today. Uh-oh. He got COVID. Oh, shit. Straight up. We can't wait for this shit. What if someone else has to do his job? Get Wile E. Coyote to set it, calibrate a catapult first so that any the dumbest scientist can walk in and make sure all the buttons get pushed to just close enough. Better than, you want to fly the V613. There's no landing gear. It's a one-way trip to the crypt, motherfucker. You want to give me your depressing confessions before we, I hope you weren't expecting to come back afterwards. What did you tell your wife before you left? Oh, brah, you want me to... I won't make this any more difficult than it already is. No, you could have told her that Mr. Schmidt had the Focke-Wulf, and she would have felt much better about it. here, you're not, that would be offensive. Yeah, no, straight up. If he said Mr. Schmidt and the fucking Focke-Wulf, good. She said Mr. Schmidt and the Focke-Wulf, yeah, shit, the Focke-Wulf. Fucking, that's the best news she would have heard all fucking day. Yeah, yeah, you know enough about these people, you can make fun of them, yeah. One of them knows, yeah, if it was just a normal, yeah, the Volksjäger motherfucker, that's why. There's a reason that one stuck with me, yeah, I like the name, but ooh, yeah, yeah, goddamn. It's like they're building Italian sports cars for the, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, so flip it around, guys, that's our insecurity. We're the ones who piss away, yeah, $1 trillion into the flaming toilets of the Bugatti factory. You know why? I cannot, you know, I'm not losing this drag race against this douchebag fucking Falco on the freeway, yeah. Yeah, whatever, it's, yeah, I can't, no, my ego can't handle that. Yeah, we did have some of the best Bugatti tanks and the really good planes, yeah, yeah. How effective was the coordinated fucking extortion racket mob unit going on? I'm just saying, guys, sorry, again, those are the comedic exaggerations. It's not untrue. It's, yeah, there are intelligent people doing this, but it's like, yeah, goddammit, we're... some people, how far ahead are you thinking? Well, what are you actually doing? Yeah, yeah, this is the result of, yeah, this sort of half-assed whatever, I'll figure it out. Well, yeah, fair enough to say we'll figure it out eventually, or I'll cross that bridge when I get to it. Yeah, bro, that's a bridge too far, mate, straight up. Well, yeah, welcome back, Scotty. Whatever, he's I got him to do a bunch of random work for us. He's not a slave, I just like to fuck with this. Yeah, it's all at your discretion, dude. You can quit the Soviet Union any day, but want to go back to fucking London, mate? Yeah, hey. Depends, are you still living in a shoebox there, so guys? That's how, yeah, welcome, comrade. You're a douchebag, but you're not a hipster douchebag. You're not fucking Prince Peppercorn, fucking, yeah. You know what I mean? You know what it's like to live in the slums, indeed. You know what it's like to be on the bottom of that pyramid. That means you're not an alien anymore. Well, sure, we're both aliens now. It's you're not, oh, those people, brah, we're both the same. We both got pushed into the same fucking corner. Yeah, yeah, well, you get to work with Salomon and Eleman, motherfucker. Now, scritchety-scratch the round table. Now it's going to be Lawrence of Arabia and Mercia first. Oh, they know it, straight up. That's a very real, yeah, guys, it's funny because it's true. No one, yeah, now we have to explain it to everyone else. That's why it's funny. So, yeah, I apologize that I'm for not being, the most professional professor. But, goddammit, even a dumb scientist who, oh, yeah, whatever, there's a reason I still call you a scientist. I don't doubt you and Shaft got 2-3 notes that make sense at this point, okay? One way or another, you know that, yeah, where's the big motherfucking bombs? We need, and what kind, yeah, how far along is our rocket technology? Whatever we have, that's your scud, yeah, yeah. Ooh, the Iron Curtain, yeah, can we nuke the Nazis? Yeah, okay, yeah, you might be, well, how do I, yeah, okay, yeah, right, you don't have to do it all yourself. You can delegate, right, I can help. If you bring me a convenient short list of, okay, if we do this, this would probably happen. Sweet, yeah, goddamn, Dr. Scientist, yeah, yeah, I'm still a bit better at this than you, but, I trust you more than those hipster fucking douchebags over there, yeah, if we need someone to show us how to use these new dildos, that, yeah, they can show us that. If I need someone to do science, yeah, exactly. Who do you think wrote the instruction manual for exactly how they have to use those dildos? Yeah, that's your job, you decide how they have to use those dildos, and then, yeah, exactly. They can show us, make sure they're all safe, and then, yeah, exactly. What are we doing with them? What are we putting in them? Where are they going? You're thinking, oh, God, yeah, how many cities are there in America? Ask an American, brah, yeah, I was thinking, some of them are very, yeah, some of them know most of them. Yeah, most of them don't know nothing about no radiation. I still have to explain how a nuke is going to kill you before I explain, yeah, you can survive a big motherfucking bomb. This is one of those things, oh yeah, take one more step, one of the, yeah, Ukrainian guys thinking, well, yeah, what do you do, straight up, if Putin goes fucking off the handle one day, hypothetically, you know, what do, crawl into the sewer, yes, into a subway, get underground, get away, yeah, dig a fucking hole to the bottom of the fucking earth and live with the mole people, that's the easy part, you get it, yeah, yeah, it doesn't take a caveman could survive a big explosion. We already did. Remember the dinosaurs 60 billion years ago? So some, yeah, your evil Nazi cat accidentally survived the biggest motherfucking bomb ever. goddamn galactic nuclear torpedo a fucking caveman hellfire. It's already, remember when that happened, right? But yeah, even the dumbest scientists, if you understand that, if you think, oh, okay, I kind of get what you're saying. Yeah, that sort of, yeah, I understand how this puzzle piece could work with some of this. Straight up, it could work with some of this. Yeah, it's not exactly the same. What else, relatively speaking, what else comes close? Chernobyl wasn't an explosion. Yeah, we'll look at the aftermath. We'll look at the aftermath after that, straight up. What it is. Yeah, you're starting to understand science. Yeah. Motherfucker, who do we Google? No, Google looks for us. Those hipster douchebags are Googling us while they're watching their hentai show, testing all the dildos. Yeah. This Kremlin dildo factory is, I told you the Russian rapist was a lady. Like, dude, this shit could work better if we knew what the fuck we were doing first. So, what's my homework? Hypothetically, what could be, what's a reasonable, I guess, for what do we do next? I can get someone to deliver you the caveman nukes. I can get them delivered to the factory to make the missiles. I can get the missiles delivered on trucks and crates. Yeah, where do you want these missiles delivered? And where should we start? You're thinking Iron Curtain, nuke the Nazis, nuke America. Nuke America. That's your job, buddy. Let's try not to be excessively wasteful. I mean, okay, you're thinking too, do we need to kill them all? What if we could blow up all their factories? The Shadow Factory, mate? Yeah, what if they have 50 underground factories? Yeah, remember? Even if we nuke the shit out of everything, the one person you are trying to kill is the only person who would survive. Yeah, and everyone else would... right. Oh, right, if that makes sense to you. Okay, let's make note of that being a bad idea. Okay, well, what about this one? Yeah. Anything that is more reasonable than... You know what I mean? And again, you might... I expect that you probably will have a dumb idea. Is it a hipster douchebag idea? Literally. Or will you instantly think, oh, of course, how could I not see that? Yeah. Well, you figured that out pretty fucking quickly. You know how hard it... Yeah, some people... Yeah, they'll figure out what radiation is one day, motherfucker. Yeah. You can show them how... Yeah, exactly how they have to use that dildo when they figure it out.
This is grade A, 100% pure Colombian cocaine, ladies and gentlemen.
Welcome back to the Black Yellow Jacket Attack Hive. We got a bunch of fucking nerds trying to hack into the hard drives. You might say some of us have fallen on some hard times. Barbed vines, more like it, a hard line to ignite all of these fucking car bombs. Bitch, now we got motherfucking smart bombs. Cruise missiles start launch. It's a hypersonic scud storm aimed right at your front door. Just watch me turn this whole fucking city into bloodborne. One more time, man, this shit don't need to rhyme, but it does need to make us all look like we might have done a crime at least one time. Yeah, I heard it on Dateline. The television told me that you raped a fucking goat, man. Yeah, that's really fucked up, dude. Why would you deny that? I guess it is woke. Give the furry cock another stroke. You should just jerk it off more to make yourself a better doormat. I know I'm not the best at this, but you probably should just ignore that. Just take this big box of Granada and I'll show you where to pour it at. Just look, one way or another, get ready for the hardcore format. And no, that doesn't mean we gotta punch each other just so we can watermark. I really hope you don't still think I do this just to piss you off. Don't be so fucking vain, that's fucking insane. Just get in the fucking plane.
Purchase your tracks today.
Systems green for emergency takeoff. Now who we gonna cook in the Saturday bake-off? I told you that thing should never break off, but since it did, that means we also have no plan to fix it. So fuck it, let's just glide until we hit the single digits on the widgets. We'll be like a little fucking midget sneaking under the radar. You should be willing to do literally anything. Skin a fucking baby alive just so we can eat something. Dinner's at 5, guys. So yeah, I hope you get the idea by now. If anything is bad to you at all whatsoever, then get the fuck back to the refugee camp and jerk off another fucking goat for me, please, you fucking whack off. and the real soldiers can go to the Grandmaster Genocide School. Kill every fucking child that you find and burn them alive. Smoke out the fucking hive, peel off their fucking skin just to make sure they really died. I know some of you get it, some of you thinking, well, what the fuck is my problem? You don't even get it, motherfucker. I really hope this doesn't sound like a fucking joke. If you think there is a rule, any rules in war, then you're fucking wrong, you're in the wrong boat. Anything goes, literally anything, motherfucking anything can go. Burning down a school, it's just another gold star on your report card. For real, man, the Sandman is ready for the grand plan. Motherfucking Yunker, stupid garbage man can. Even if it means taking nukes straight to Japan. You don't think the motherfucking Shogunator knows about this shit? I told you, toss his fucking grandma out the castle if she became the next emperor or some shit. Oh, she knows, you get too high and mighty in the palace and here comes a motherfucking Shijinko. We'll get back to it. Anyway, what the fuck were we platting it? If you're not ready to drive over a child in the mud tracks and motherfucking butcher some babies or whatever, you will definitely regret getting involved in this or that. It always happens no matter what. Sure, you can rationalize it anyway, the loose ends tie, even if it's Dr. Evil, motherfucker's still gonna die. You still gotta burn them babies alive. I hope you enjoy fetus fries. Come on, laugh it up, motherfucker. Get the salt shaker for the burning babies. Get the fuck out of the truck. This is just the first part of a long day of getting fucked up. If you didn't want to kill a bunch of people, why the fuck did you even come here? Motherfucking dumbass motherfuckers, goddamn.